In this video, we are going to see the Singleton Pattern, what it is, what advantages it has, the specific way in which it is implemented in Godot, and of course, how to use it. The Singleton Pattern is a very versatile software design pattern widely used both in traditional software development and in the video game industry. Basically, it allows us to have a single instance of a class. To illustrate it, I have created this small demo in which I can control this character. I can move it and I can also fire her weapon. If you look in the upper left corner, I have a bullet counter. However, when I move to the right and go to a new scene, the bullet counter has reset and I have 8 bullets again instead of the ones I had left. In this video, we're going to first understand what the Singleton pattern is, and then we will see how to use Godot's autoload function, which is the way in which Godot has implemented this pattern, to solve this problem and be able to maintain the bullet counter even when moving between scenes. This pattern is brilliantly explained in the legendary book Game Programming Patterns, along with many other design patterns, all applied to the world of video game development. Contains explanations and practical examples for this pattern and many other useful patterns. You can access this book online, but if you prefer to delve into it physically, I leave you a purchase link in the video description. Without further ado, let's learn about the Singleton pattern and how to implement it in the Godot game engine. Using the Singleton pattern allows us to have a single instance of a given class through a single access point. Let's take as an example a game that needs to keep the state of the character, including its health and also the remaining bullets to shoot, just like the demo I showed you before. In this game, we have a class that manages the player's stats. To use this class, we need to instantiate it in every scene. But then we have the problem that if the character transitions to another scene, this class is re-instantiated and the stats are reset. By using the Singleton pattern, we can have a single instance of this class that is used in each of the scenes, solving our original problem. This pattern also provides other advantages, for example, reduced memory usage, given that by having a single instance of a class and not many, the memory needed to host that level of data is less. Another advantage of this pattern is that it helps in synchronizing resources that are accessible for multiple threads. By ensuring that only one instance of the class will be used, all those same threads will use that same instance. Let's now see an example of an implementation in C#. We have a class called PlayerStats that contains a property called RemainingBullets, which is responsible for managing the number of remaining bullets. The typical implementation of the Singleton pattern includes a private static property of the type of this same class, and a public static method like this that checks if the instance has been initialized, initializes it if it hasn't, and returns it. In this way, when calling this instance method, we will always obtain the same instance of the class if it's created, and if it's not, it will be created, stored in the private underscore instance variable and then return it. I am showing you this example to give you an idea of how to do a raw implementation of a singleton. It is in C#, since in GDScript it's not possible to create static members. Now, in order to implement this pattern in Godot, it won't be necessary to do all this, since Godot does an implementation in its own way and it's called autoload. Let's move on to the practical part of this video, where you will see how easy it is to implement this pattern using the autoload feature in Godot. This is my example project, which, if you remember, had a character that could move and shoot. When I move to the right, I make a scene change and the bullet counter resets. This is because I currently have the bullet counter in this variable, which is in the player class. We are going to create a singleton class that manages the player's stats. For this, I create a directory called singleton. And inside, I create this script named playerstats.gd. Now, all I have to do is move the variable that counts the player's bullets to this new class. Next, to tell Godot that I want this class to become a singleton and be accessible from any scene, I go to Project, Project Settings, then the Autoload tab. Here, I press this button to select the script that I just created. I leave the class name as it is and click on the Add button. From now on, this class is accessible from any script in the project. Now, the only thing I have to do is replace the use I made of the variable with playerStats.remainingBullets. This way, the character's script will use this variable to count the bullets it has left. But since there is only one instance of this class, it does not matter if we change the scene. The variables in player stats will always retain their value. As you can see, implementing the singleton pattern in Godot using autoload is super simple. You can use this functionality to store, for example, the state of your main character, their health level, their inventory, adverse effects that may be affecting them, etc. Another very interesting pattern to learn in Godot is the observer pattern, which is implemented through the use of signals. This pattern will help you to apply a communication mechanism between components in a clean and efficient way. If you want to learn about the observer pattern and the use of signals in Godot, click on the suggested video that you see on the screen. If you found this video useful, I ask you to press the like button and subscribe to my channel to see more content like this. I hope you have a beautiful rest of your day. Goodbye.